Hello everyone, my name is Szymon Klos and I'm contracted by the Tirana for over 1 year. I want to show you results of the paper. It was mainly focused on PPTX support. I think last year there was a similar talk. Thomas and I explained some new features last year, like group shapes for exporting embedded videos, and now I would like to show new features like the filming of the document colors, improved charting or text effects. I will start with the most important part, I think. It's common that exporting PPTX file caused the output file to be imported. So it means that after we opened this in Microsoft Office, there was a small window that you can see on the top of this slide, showing that the file is completely incorrect. And we had about 25 cases of that behavior. It was found by error and syscall. And so this problem was solved by a group of people. For example, me, my friend, Jan Kaleszowski, and Thomas Zolny. The root cause of these problems, I noticed, was because we had that pattern in export code. So it means that we had an open element and a closed element, but no content inside, which should be some required element. Most of these bugs were related to animations, where we have many types of animations, but only one structure to save them. It is done mostly by elements to and from. So we can save many ranges like color, transition, or position, movement, or time. So we can save everything in this one element, but to represent the data, we need many types of value, and only integer value was supported before. So I added string time and floating point time to say, for example, position per part. This bugs related mostly to zoom animation or color transform or drawing screen motion and many more. During my work, I also noticed that we have incompatible value of transition time, and we use only one enum with three values for saving this time, while in Microsoft Office you can have custom value, like 1 second and half. I converted this value to numbers instead of enum, and now we can export any value we want. One corner case was 0 seconds where Microsoft Office saves a very small number, and when we did that export with 0 seconds, we also had a open window of that export. Next pieces were mostly related to document. For example, it was a problem First line, there is normal spacing, and it should be shorter. How can I fix this issue? Not this, but in many other cases, when line spacing is more than 1.0, there is the same problem. So I can fix all of these things. And the next problem was it's what we've automatically scaled font inside the text box. We have that feature that when we have automatic scaling and we have sharing when it is big, we can read from that. When it's smaller, we scale this font to be inside this shape, and LibreOffice has no problem, but after we exported our file and opened in Microsoft Office, it was like something like this, because I found an element, an attribute, font scale, which is used by Microsoft Office probably to reduce loading time, and they don't recalculate this scaling values before we edit something. So I had to add this factor to fix this issue. One of the new features is support for document color filling. I was surprised that in code we have very big piece of hard-coded XML and it is copied to each document. I had to do some rework and add import part and export part for document color to present these values. But so now document is correct, but we don't have the possibility to edit this, so we need some small UI. I think it's a good idea to create a new research project or something like that for this. And you can see here these two issues. It was stated before, we have shifted text and run colors. And after my fixes, it looks like this. You may notice also that chart was changed, so these are the next features. Before we had an issue with position of labels, and as you can see, these labels are only a plain text, only single line, and when we had very, very long label like this, shortening should be used, and also the regulations need to add some fields into these labels like row or column from data source. I implemented these features, and as you can see, we have these elements like multi-lines, text is formatted, can have different colors for size, and also we have few fields like value in this case and color and range in this case. Next thing is the text effects, because when we doing some diagrams, sometimes we need text following the shape of shape behind it, like in this example where we have the text on the curve. So before it was exported and imported as a normal text and completely shifted. So I converted these text boxes to font work and finished. like